From the University of South Carolina, your news, your sports, your weather. Carolina News begins now.
Welcome to Carolina News FastCast. I'm Darby Horn, and thank you for joining us this afternoon. Jumping right into weather, the Southeast is currently picking up the pieces from severe storm damage this past weekend. In Alabama, a Category 4 tornado has left 23 dead in Lee County. And right here in Columbia, three touchdowns Sunday night. Neighborhoods just north of the Riverbank Zoo received the worst of the damage due to the tornado's 95-mile-per-hour winds. Weather has been a bit of a whirlwind from high temperatures to tornadoes, but the next concern for Columbia is the freezing temperatures we are expecting this week. Maggie, let's take a look at the five-day forecast.
Thanks, Darby. We're going to look at the five-day forecast, and we are going to see some colder weather right now. As we look on Wednesday, it is going to be only a high of 50 degrees, though we are going to see some sun. And as we look at Thursday as well, it is going to be around the same temperature with a high of 58 degrees and sunny weather as well. When we look into Friday, unfortunately, we're going to get into some afternoon showers, but it is going to warm up at a high of 63 degrees. As we head into the weekend, we're going to see mostly cloudy on Saturday with a high of 70, and Sunday we're going to see more of thunderstorms, though it is going to be a little bit warmer at a high of 74 degrees. Back to you, Darby.
The great Mega Millions lottery mystery has been solved. With only 48 days left to claim their winnings, the $1.5 billion lottery winner has finally cashed in, anonymously. The ticket was purchased in Simpsonville, South Carolina on October 23rd, and because the ticket is claimed, the state will now receive $61 million in income taxes, and the KC Mart No. 7, the store the ticket was purchased at, will receive $50,000. A Lexington County EMS employee is being charged with third-degree assault and battery, and the victim? A 7-year-old. 44-year-old Scott Anthony Ludwig was restraining a Newbridge Academy student for behavioral transport when Ludwig struck the child in the face with an open hand. Lexington detectives say that Ludwig's response was caused by the child's attempt to bite his arm. Ludwig turned himself in at the sheriff's office on Monday afternoon, and he is currently being held at the Lexington County Detention Center. Next, we go over to Daniel with our local sports news.
Welcome to the Carolina News Sports Fast Track, where I'll be telling you what's happening in the sports world right now in under a minute. Well, it's a great time to be a Gamecock as numerous spring sports are ranked in the top 25. After beating Clemson this weekend in the Palmetto Series, the Carolina baseball team is now ranked 20th, according to Baseball America. The women's tennis team is ranked 10th in the nation, and the softball team is at number 13 in the latest NCAA poll. College basketball is wrapping up as teams prepare to make one last push for the NCAA tournament. But before the NCAA tournament is the conference tournament, and the women's basketball team is looking to claim their fifth straight SEC ring. After a successful regular season, the team has earned a bye in the tournament and won't have to play until March 8th in the quarterfinals. The opponent is to be determined. And last but not least, we finished the segment with a little bit of girl power. Lexi Piddlecow of Lugoff Elgin High School is the first female to make a pitching debut for a high school baseball team in the Midlands. Piddlecow also plays infield and is just the second girl in South Carolina history to play for a high school program. Thanks for tuning in into the Fast Track Sports segment. I'm Daniel Carter. Thanks so much for watching.
And now for our FastCast top five stories of the day. More than 80 people were arrested last night during a Sacramento protest, including a reporter and clergy members. The protest was over prosecutors declining to file charges against officers who shot unarmed Stephen Clark last March. In Alabama, a man is now being charged with the murder of a missing 11-year-old girl, recently found dead near his house. Hillary Clinton puts rumors to rest after announcing she will not be running for president in 2020. She plans to continue to speak out on politics, saying, quote, she will not be going anywhere, end quote. President Trump and the White House have denounced the sweeping new investigation launched by the House Judiciary Committee. This probe could potentially help Democrats if they choose to proceed with impeachment proceedings against the president. Scientists believe a London patient in remission may be the second person cured of HIV. Both patients received stem cell transplants from donors who are resistant to the disease. That's it for Carolina FastCast. We'll be right back tomorrow at 3:00.